Hi everyone! Today we're talking about histology, and our topic is connective tissue. As you may already know, we have different tissues that are defined as connective, since their main role is to separate and support all the other components of our body. Regarding its embryological origin, connective tissue derives from the mesenchyme, a tissue developing mainly from the middle layer of the embryo, the mesoderm. Speaking about the connective tissue, we must distinguish between the cell population and the extracellular matrix. The cell population of connective tissue, so the cells located in it, is composed by resident cells, which are permanently located in the tissue and collaborate actively to its architecture, and these are fibroblasts, chondroblasts, osteoblasts, and mast cells. Then there are migrating cells, that are cells which are usually found in the bloodstream. However, they are able to extravasate in order to carry out their role related to the immune response. Among them, there are macrophages, granulocytes, and lymphocytes. In the extracellular matrix, two components can be found, the fibrillary component and the ground substance. The fibrillary components form the supporting structure of the tissue. These are collagen fibers, elastic fibers, and reticular fibers. While the ground substance is the most abundant component, and it contributes to the spread of substances from capillaries to tissue cells. It is composed of water, electrolytes, glycoproteins, GAGs, proteoglycans, and enzymes. Let's now talk more in detail about the fibrillary components. Firstly, collagen fibers are abundantly present, flexible, and resistant to tensile stress. These fibers have a wavy and compound structure. Three alpha chains wrapped around one another in a helical configuration. This combination in triplets gives rise to tropocollagen. Tropocollagen is then exported through the cell membrane and afterward combined spontaneously in a head-to-tail fashion to form microfibrils that organize in fibrils. We have 29 types of collagen, depending on the presence of glycine, proline, and hydroxyproline in the alpha chains. The most frequent collagen typologies are type 1 collagen, which is the most abundant protein in our body. It is ubiquitous and resistant to force, tear, and stretch, and we can observe it in bones. Type 2 molecule is especially resistant to intermittent stress and therefore it is found in intervertebral discs and cartilage. Type 3 is found in skin and forms reticular fibers. Secondly, elastic fibers are necessary to balance the stiffness of collagen fibers. These proteins are thin and are characterized by a core of elastin surrounded by microfibrils and fibrils externally. They are abundant in skin, blood vessels, lungs, and bladder. The last fibrillary component is reticular fibers, which we have already mentioned, since they are made by collagen type 3, which forms a network not organized in bundles. Reticular fibers are not very strong, and their main function is scaffolding. They surround adipocytes, small blood vessels, and they're present in epithelial tissues. Let's have a look now to ground substance. Ground substance is a viscous and clear compound, which is abundant in water and proteins. It cannot be observed at light microscope due to the fact that it is dispersed during the staining procedure. The main components of ground substance are glycosaminoglycans or GAGs, and these are long chains of unbranched polysaccharides, which are the main component of proteoglycans. Proteoglycans are molecules formed by a core protein of hyaluronic acid surrounded by 1 to 200 glycosaminoglycans covalently attached to it. Finally, we observe glycoproteins of different types. They are multifunctional and stabilize the extracellular matrix and help in linking it to the cell surface. Also, They have binding sites for various proteins and are related to cell proliferation and differentiation. An example are fibroconnectin and laminin. We conclude with connective tissue classification. We can identify three categories of connective tissues: proper, supportive, and special. Let's begin with proper connective tissue, which is itself divided in four types. The loose connective tissue is ubiquitous, viscous, and contains more ground substance than fibers. It is most frequently found in the tunica mucosa and submucosa of hollow organs, tunica intima of blood vessels, and stroma of solid organs. It helps in the structural organization and contributes with the immune system and with distribution of nutrients and removal of waste. In addition, there is the dense connective tissue, which is distinguished in dense regular and dense irregular. Dense regular tissue has fewer cells compared to loose connective tissue, and its extracellular matrix is densely packed with thick collagen fibers aligned in parallel to each other. The parallel arrangement allows the tissue to resist the stress, and this feature is fundamental for tendons and ligaments to bear strong stretches. In dense irregular, the cellular component is still lower than loose connective tissue, but in this case, the collagen fibers are interwoven. The ground substance is scarce, and the fibroblasts are isolated by the thick network that characterizes this subtype of connective tissue. Another proper connective tissue is the reticular connective tissue, which has a higher cellular content and it has a branched and mesh-like pattern due to the arrangement of its fibers. It functions as a connecting stroma in liver, kidneys, and lymph nodes. Furthermore, there is the mucous connective tissue, which is a very loose connective tissue. It mainly contains ground substance and has a gelatinous consistence. It is located in the dental pulp, in the aqueous humor of the eye, and in the umbilical cord. For what concerns supportive connective tissue, we have cartilage and bones. While special connective tissue forms blood, bones, and cartilage, and it will be explored in a subsequent video.